Plus a C Radio. I love you.
To you, and to you listening to me on air, online, wherever you are, however you're listening, it does feel so good to be back on the radio. I've been gone for, what, 4 days? It's been a long, much-deserved long break. You're welcome back from the holidays. If you did have a holiday, you're tuned into Asasi Radio, the voice of our land. This is Between Hours. My name is Na Ashoko. I'm your host. And oh, I'm so thrilled to say you're welcome back to a working week. Charlie, how was your weekend? My weekend started real, like, it was not cool. So I closed work early on Thursday and I said, Charlie, today, yeah, I'm going to sleep. I left the office at 3 p.m. I stayed in traffic till 11 p.m. and I'm not even playing. What was happening in town last Thursday? The traffic was sick. But yeah, the holidays were good for me. I slept a lot. I got a lot of me time. And I hope you did too. We're back on the radio. And today, I'm going to be talking to a lady who started trending long before the internet. Y'all think you trend? You do a few hashtags, your pictures are on a few pages, and you think you are trending. I tell you about a lady whose trending started long before the internet. She was trending long before Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube. She was in every home, at every airport. She was all over the place. I've looked, and I found her. Today, I'm going to be talking to the Akwaba lady. You know the lady in the cool kente up, down, and turban on all of those Akwaba posters? Yep, she's here. And oh my God, she is so beautiful. She's my guest today on the show. DJ Perfect has lots of music for us today. I'm looking forward to getting your messages and calls. And in between all of that, I hope you do have a wonderful time listening to the show. You're welcome. Here's our first song by Adina, and she calls it On My Way.
Mic check, 1, 2. Playlist B, Adina. Let me talk to me. Life is short, so you for live and well, well. Oh. If you get a chance, oh, cafe door. My party for hot, so well, well. Oh. So life go be jaja, oh. If you never know what you really want, it never go be jaja, oh. I'm on my way to the top. I never fear, no, I never stop. I ain't thinking to fall back. I keep on moving. True to who you are. Yes, I dear, I'm sorry. worry. My party for hustle, well, well, oh. So life go be jeje, oh. If you never know what you really want, it never go be jeje, oh. My party for hustle, well, well, oh. So life go be jeje, oh. If you never know what you really want, it never go be jeje, oh.
Anybody, and so wish you out, wish you out. And your boy, no. See, so I do hustle, no, they make chance pass me by. So make you do your best and use your sense. I show the stress since I put God first. Charlie, it no be race, it no be test. And Jah guide to no one can test. So make you tell them. So we do come, no, they fear them. Baba, God, do for my side, so no shaking.
Yeah, when you're media, on Chonko now, on do. On in the CCTV, they be an anyone so. Even if I walk through the valley of death, I know the fear. Every day be your guide. Yeah, yeah, when you're media, on Chonko now, on do. On in the CCTV, they be an anyone so. Even if I walk through the valley of death,
my pity make you no cry, you still try. Say ego be make you no cry. You my draw money, yeah, want me and die. Quit. I don't mean a song, I don't mean a dim me. I don't mean a dim me, chin team in China, China. Don't mean a song, I don't mean a dim me. Oh, yeah, team in China, China.
Yeah, when you're media. CCTV, they be an anyone so. Even if I walk through the valley of death, I know the fear. Every day be your guide. Yeah, yeah, when you're media, on Chonko now, on do. On in the CCTV, they be an anyone so. Even if I walk through the valley of death,
the enemy won't worry me. I go show all of them tragedy. No be today, no be today. We start to. So if I sing my song, if I keep up for long, because you don't know that day, Jesus Christ, he go come. So if you see me today, I know my love. I know my love. Oh, my love. Anybody pop his pen today? I mean, I can go for that. They can't. Lonely, lonely story. But I tie my mind, my Toyota. Flossy, come on, get banging. What a lovely story. I don't live this life, yo. Because I got my Bible, yo. Because the blessings I get from the Most High is so great, though. So if you see me today. I know my love. I know my love. Oh,
something. And I go buy the motor for mama. But the enemy won't worry me. I go show all of them tragedy. No be today, no be today. We start to. So if I sing my song, if I keep up for long, because you don't know that day, Jesus Christ.
Between hours.
Very good band, yeah.
My friend, just so far.
don't feel my heart. Yeah, you're too sexy, nah. You're too bad, you're too naughty. Oh, I get to some Pepsi. Me to talk to my body, I want you know. Me to the cell, be a moment. Me to talk to my body.
Between hours.
Special Easter request from all of us. I'm the matron of the former girlfriends association to current boyfriends. Wami, music by Stoneboy, bringing us to exactly 25 minutes past 2 p.m. You're tuned into Assassin Radio, the voice of our land. Thank you, DJ Pepe, for back-to-back hits for our afternoon enjoyment. Now, right after these messages, I'm going to be talking to a very phenomenal lady. This lady, she was a trendsetter before trends were cool. She was trending before anyone thought of the word trend. The lady on the Akwaba poster. You know that fine lady with the turban, kente, the kente outfit that all the 80s babies did. Then you were born in the 80s, right? And you didn't do that turban thing. I don't expect the Calipo and the Indomie generation to understand. But those of us from the interior generation, we know what we're talking about. She's here, and I should tell you, she is just as beautiful as the poster. Stay tuned. You're listening to Between Hours live on Assassin Radio. My name is Nasha Kaw. We'll be right back.
Right in the city of Accra, 30 minutes drive from the Kutuka International Airport, the Knightsbridge is Africa's first affordable luxury housing. The 1, 2, and 3-bedroom luxury apartments feature a gorgeous living area with natural illumination, a well-fitted kitchen, and a master bedroom with stunning ensuite and the perfect bathroom for you. With breathtaking views, the Knightsbridge contemporary lifestyle is the norm. It's the perfect community. 1, 2, and 3-bedroom apartments available starting from $27,500. Contact us now 0204-9508-10 or 0208-708-435. You can visit us on our website at www.rehobothpropertiesgh.com or email us sales@rehobothpropertiesgh.com. Accra was officially declared the commercial capital of Africa on the 27th of October 2020 at the 4th Ghana International Trade and Finance Conference, GITFIC, by the Senior Minister of Ghana, the Mayor of Accra, and industry titans. Africa. The Continental Free Trade Area, AFCFTA, is headquartered in Accra. The National Investment Bank, the B5 Plus Group, and the Bank of Ghana support this initiative. Visit gitfic.com or accra-commercialcapital.com to learn more. Accra, commercial capital of Africa. This public notice is brought to you by Asasi Radio. Africa.
For Pepsodent, smiles are one of the most important things we have. The problem is, globally, one in two children suffer from cavities. Pepsodent, with maximum cavity protection, helps to prevent the formation of cavities. Pepsodent, because every smile matters. This advertisement has been vetted and approved by the FDA.
I nearly gave up on driving out of frustration. What hadn't I done? Purging, replacing electrical parts, changing my fuel pump, and still, the engine noise in my car won't stop. Then I met this guy who said I should try Goil Fuel. By the way, my name is Thomas, but I did try Goil Super XP Run 95. And
Goil stocks only higher grade fuels, further enriched with XP3 multifunctional enhancer. More efficient, eco-friendly, and at no extra cost. Available at every Goil station. Ajibebia.
Now my car is renewed. Yankonkwa.
Goil Super XP Run 95 and Diesel XP. Higher grade fuels. Excellent for modern engines. In all vehicles, Goil, good energy. Yeah.
Now, me say, a free brammy who the beer we are active, very strong and energetic.
We are 100%. Nanina, Nisadia, me shamini pedia sofa, Nadia Buamia, Mama Hording, Mammy Timuko Bada, and the Tabia Zanica herba, Mister.
Tabia Zanica herba, Mister. Ah, what do you want to answer, Chamber?
What dance here, dear? And Yawunko, and made the Dorin Atoso. Now, my dear Tani Pampim, Tabia Zanica. Heba Mister, ma tuni din yamiyama. Sawunuma, emen kwamwa, ewo ni pedria numwa, ye fremwa soja fuo, eye white blasters na wadin, enti ni pedria ni nya wadin sronko, kutia yaria hudwa bebre, enti unta nyare, enti na dame ye strong no, eye general well-being of the body, enti ye juma, ewo ni pedria na kwa numu bebia.
Miya mitumihu, enye sebu suye biye,
eye busu yen chenfa, si obidi na hutu tabia zenike heba Mister soa, e din si obe yari, nenyena, ewo bebia tuntu edro biya, si anansu se, obi Finche Dumienu, a painful, and your batania, or more man of war, ain't me numbi. FDA, I shall say, I get the encatromo, I get to me say.
Right in the city of Accra, 30 minutes drive from the Kotoka International Airport, the Knightsbridge is Africa's first affordable luxury housing. The 1, 2, and 3 bedroom luxury apartments feature a gorgeous living area with natural illumination. A well-fitted kitchen and a master bedroom with stunning ensuite and the perfect bathroom for you. With breathtaking views, the Knightsbridge contemporary lifestyle is the norm. It's the perfect community. 1, 2, and 3 bedroom apartments available starting from $27,500. Contact us now 0204-9508-10 or 0208-708-435. You can visit us on our website at www.rehobothpropertiesgh.com or email us sales@rehobothpropertiesgh.com.
This is Asasi Radio.
Kese, music by Ohima Mercy, and especially going out to all of you listening to me right now. Wobeye Kese, and I don't mean you're going to put on weight or any of that. No. God will make you great, because this week, he arose, he risen, he has aroused. Charlie, the things I read yesterday, but you guys, you know, you can just say Happy Easter and get on with it. But he arisen, he arose, he aroused, and things I was reading on social media yesterday, goodness. Well, he is risen, and because of that, we are saved, and we are all about to have a fantastic week. So, I'm sorry. My producer just said he has resigned. Seriously, Charlie, I'm out for Chromo. Happy Easter, and one no more person more trouble for Kesiesa. Anyway, this song especially going out to Vianna Ngazi at TV3. It's your birthday today. Happy birthday, Vianna, from Kezia here at Asasi Radio. And even more specially, this song is going out to Miss Odro here in our studios. Angelina Nana Ekia Odro, Mami Akwaba. How are you?
I'm fine.
Oh my goodness. If you just tuned in, I'm joined by the lady on the Akwaba poster. You know that Akwaba poster was a fine lady, beautiful smile, kente cloth around her waist, you know, with a turban. That nice Akwaba picture that all the gang girls of our time went to flash photos at Otu Dakwa Circle roundabout. That photo that we all took. The lady, the owner of that, are you the owner of the copyright? You know what? Let's go back. How are you doing?
I'm good.
I'm so happy you're here. Because you're one mega superstar in our country and beyond. Do you feel that way? No?
I feel like a normal person will feel. I don't feel like I'm a superstar.
You don't feel like you're a superstar? But do you know that you're a superstar? Not really? You don't think about it?
I feel normal, actually.
I guess that you feel normal, yeah. Because you seem like a really cool lady.
Yeah.
But do you know, I mean, aside feeling, do you know that, okay, you're a big, hot shot superstar?
People say it,
but you don't agree.
I agree.
You agree? Because you are. How long ago did you do this?
I took it about 22 years ago.
22 years ago? And which year was that? That's like, I don't know, my math is bad. So 1999?
Yeah.
1999. How old were you?
I was around 17, 18 years.
You were a teenager?
Yeah.
Wow. How old are you now?
39. I'll be 40 this year.
You'll be 40?
Yeah.
Goodness. You look almost the same. Like, when I saw you walk in, I thought, I know her. She looks familiar. I know her. And then, well, it's good to have you on the show.
Thank you.
So 22 years later, what has changed in your life? Tell me about when you first took the picture. What was the plan for it? Was it supposed to be something for everybody? Was it your personal picture? What went into taking that picture?
Okay. When I was a kid, we used to live around Dance Bar, North Kanishi Dance Bar. And that bar, there's a bar there.
Yeah, I know Dance Bar.
Yes, Dance Bar. The owner had a picture of a painting of a woman with calabash. And she had beads. And she was pouring palm wine.
Okay.
And anytime my mom sent me and I get there, I'll just look at the woman and I'll say, I'll grow up to be like you. And it's like the picture was looking at me. She was looking straight into my eyes. So okay. Sometimes when I get there, I'll look at her and I'll smile as if I'm communicating with her.
Oh.
Yeah. So when I grew up, I met a friend who was also into photography. And around that time, I was with Data Plaha and Supermodel Agency.
Mm-hmm.
So I think maybe pictures, things. And then all of a sudden, I remember that, oh, yeah, I wanted to take this picture.
Mm-hmm.
So can you please help me? And he said, oh, no problem. I'll help you take the picture. Then we took the picture.
And then what was the plan for the picture?
The picture, what the plan was to put in my hall, because I told him that I wanted to take the picture. I want to make it very big.
Mm-hmm.
I had wanted it to be very big, like the woman's picture. The woman's picture was
the painting.
Very big. Yeah, the painting. I wanted to be like hers, but we decided to we'll make it big, but it wouldn't be like hers, and we put it in my hall. So after the picture was ready, he told me that it's like people were admiring the picture, so let's just sell it. So that's how it just went viral like that.
So he sold how many copies of the picture?
I can't tell. But
so did he make so many of them and sell them?
Yes. So at the beginning, people started patronizing it little by little. And within some few months and weeks, it just went viral.
How much did he sell it for?
I can't tell
So was it his money or your money?
Anytime he sells the pictures, then you come and tell me that, oh, this is what I had, so take yours.
How much did he give you?
Around that time, I don't remember, actually.
Was it a lot of money?
to me, around that time, it was a lot of money for me.
Okay.
Yeah.
So did all the copies come from him, or did other people start producing theirs?
I think later people started producing, because I remember I met someone who told me it was from Japan, and I'll meet someone and say, this is from Togo. People started producing some, so...
Wow. Yeah. Did he ever sign the picture, or was there anything to show that, okay, this was his work?
No, there was
nothing.
There was nothing like that. I think maybe it was because we didn't plan to sell it.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't expect anything to come out of it like that. So,
okay.
Yeah.
So tell me about the Akwaba. When he printed the picture, did he write Akwaba on it, or someone else took the picture and decided to put Akwaba on it? And then, because we know you as the Akwaba girl.
Yeah.
So did he put Akwaba on it?
Yeah, he put
Akwaba. He wrote the Akwaba.
He decided to write Akwaba.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Tell me how you felt as a teenager then, seeing that people were buying your picture.
Around that time, I felt good, because it's like, I remember I had a friend who used to call me to, be a judge at programs. I had a lot of privileges, and I felt good around that time.
Okay.
Yeah.
You felt good.
Yeah, I felt
you were
good.
A judge,
yes.
On beauty pageants and
yes,
stuff.
Yes.
I see. How about your parents? Did they know you were taking that picture?
Initially, my father didn't like the idea when the pictures went viral. I remember he called me and he warned me that, what are you doing? Don't you know that you are exposing yourself to the world? You can die. Someone can take your picture and do anything to you through the picture. I don't like what you're doing. He got angry. But later, he was okay. He became okay, because just like a normal Ghanaian, if he sees his daughter or son doing anything without his knowledge or something, you get angry. So he was angry initially, but he's cool now.
How about your mother?
My mother is the... She
doesn't talk much.
Yes, she doesn't talk much.
Okay. How about the people in your life, like church, your cousins and so on?
My whole family, they are all so proud. I said, my dad is very proud.
I mean, when you did it at first?
At first, he didn't like the idea, because he was scared for his daughter. Yes, but he's now proud. My church, I now fellowship with Love Community Chapel. My church is so proud of me.
So many years later.
Yeah.
I see. Interesting. So after the picture went viral and people started reproducing it, I mean, it's everywhere. I mean, in most Ghanaian homes abroad, you see that picture. Do you ever get any IP rights for it?
There was nothing like that.
Have you ever tried to, have you ever hired a lawyer to say, okay, this is my image, this is my work, I would like to be paid something for it?
When Glow came to Ghana, Glow, they contacted me and they asked me, and I called the manager. He was the manager around that time. I called him and I told him that Glow wanted to use my picture for this, so what should we do? And he told me that I should tell him that I've been paid off. So I told him exactly that. And later I didn't hear from them again. I don't know. But later a friend told me that no, you have to get a lawyer and get you go to copyright. So I took a lawyer around that time. And we went to copyright, and copyright told us that it's not going to work, because so many years, I can't get the rights. So I left it like that.
How old were you when Glow came to Ghana?
The year that Glow came to Ghana, I don't remember the exact year.
You don't remember how old you were at the time?
I don't remember the exact year, but I think...
But a manager told you to tell Glow that you had been paid off.
The man
who took the picture.
Yes, I called him.
So he told you to tell Glow that you had been paid off.
Yes.
And you told Glow you'd been paid. But had you been paid off?
I was a child, so that is what he said I should say.
Did you ask your parents?
Around that time, I think Glo came to Ghana around 12 years, I think 12 years ago, 13, I don't remember that, but around that time, I didn't tell my parents because around that time I was married. I've been married before, I'm divorced now. Around that time I was married with, I think I had, my daughter was, I was married around that time. So I called him, I called him and he told me, he told me, tell them you've been paid off. Me, I thought maybe if I say that, it's cool. But later, a friend told me I shouldn't have said that.
Yeah,
I didn't know. So that's what I told Glo. I didn't
Did Glo use the picture?
They didn't use the picture. Wow. I didn't hear from them again. And so it was after that I discussed with a friend. And a friend told me that, I think you have to go for the copyright. You have to go to copyright. Go find a lawyer. And then we tried. It didn't work out. And
so you've been to the copyright office.
Yes.
Did you go with a lawyer?
Yeah, I went there with the lawyer.
And what were you told?
And we were told that we should have registered it around within 6 months. And so many years, we can't do anything about it. It's like they were even laughing.
No, 6 months. That's not correct, though.
It says something like that. Then they said, it's so many years now. And
yeah, it falls into general use. I mean, I'm not a lawyer, so I stand to be corrected. But it falls into general use a number of years after you have died.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So we were even made fun of. They told us. I think I used to have that particular guy. I don't have his number now, but that's what he told me.
Okay.
So
that's very unfortunate because that's not correct.
Okay.
That's not correct at all. And I still think it's not too late.
Okay.
You can still claim it. For the people who already have it, they already have it. But for people who are reproducing in Japan, people are reproducing in China, people are reproducing in America and so on, you deserve some money for your image rights, I believe. But anyway, away from the money conversation, how is your life now? What do you do?
I do fashion designing. I do hats and fascinators.
Okay.
I recently learned how to bridal makeup.
Oh, yeah, you look very beautiful.
Thank you. And I do balloon and floral deco too.
Did you ever think of modeling as?
I used to model.
Okay.
Yeah. I used to model with Supermodel Agency.
Okay.
Yeah.
Back in before this whole thing started.
Yeah, before this whole thing
started. But after you became so famous, did you think, okay, I can make some money taking pictures and, you know, modeling? Do you have any other viral pictures aside that one?
No, apart from that.
Okay.
I think I got married after 3 years. I got married around 23, 24 years. So, and I decided to go low.
Yeah. Why?
A whole lot of.
Tell me, I'm interested.
Okay. Maybe pregnancy and taking care of family, baby, maybe.
Okay. So you got married, you had one baby, you had two babies, you thought, okay, I need to what?
I'm divorced now.
Okay, but I'm asking, like, back then, you know, you are this very popular girl. Everyone thinks you're so beautiful. You are, when we, out there, when people think of a Ghanaian girl, you're the one they think of. And you had, like, the world at your feet. And I'm just curious to know why, after you got married, I mean, you were still young, 24, you're still very young, you didn't think you could continue modeling or, you know. Was there something else?
I'll leave that for another time.
But there was something else.
Yes.
Okay. It's okay if you don't want to talk about it, because I'm just really curious, because look at that picture. I would like to see a different variation 10 years later, 20 years later.
Yeah.
You know?
You're going to make another.
You need to hire somebody. Hire a lawyer, hire a team, and make something beautiful of it.
I now have a lawyer and a team.
So you're working on it.
Yes, please.
What advice would you give to young girls like you? I mean, at the time, you're a very popular girl. I'm sure at the time your classmates and your friends would see you and think, oh my God, our friend has made it. Mama, she's made it. You know, you must have been the it girl at the time.
Yeah.
Do you still feel that way with your friends?
For now, I don't have a lot of friends.
Okay.
I only have a few friends. Yeah.
May I ask why?
Maybe life experience.
Can you share some experiences with us?
Nah.
Okay, so I'm 32 years old, right?
Okay.
I also started doing things when I was 19. Okay. And I never stopped. I got married around the same age you got married. I got married at 25.
Okay.
And I have two children too.
Okay.
So I'm just listening to you and I'm just trying to learn something from you because you're older than me. I'm 32, right? So I'm just trying to learn a thing or two from you because I think in some way we have maybe a similar story. Maybe in some way, but both came out when we were teenagers, but we're all over the place. My friends would think I was an it girl at that time. Right now, I don't know. I don't really know, but that's why I'm asking you all these questions.
Maybe a childbirth, and because when around the time I was around 19, 20 years, I used to like clubbing. And what, getting married, I wouldn't have to. I started not having time to go to the club because I got pregnant. So maybe the friends, I started saving them from that time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Have you ever tried to get help from like the Ministry of Tourism or the Creative Arts Secretariat and so on for this, you know?
Yeah, we've tried them, but nothing concrete coming out yet.
What they tell you?
We're still working on it.
You're still talking to them.
Yeah.
What do you want to do should it work out?
I want to be the ambassador.
For?
For arts, maybe.
Like culture, a tourism ambassador.
Tourism ambassador, yeah.
Because recently some tourism ambassadors have been hired. And you will be a perfect fit for a tourism ambassador. Because you already are.
I hope so.
You already are. I mean, you are the picture of a Ghanaian girl in many homes across the world is you. So I guess you're already, you know, an ambassador, so to speak. Well, I hope that goes through for you.
I hope too.
And should you become an ambassador, what would you do? Like, what's your plan? What's the big idea?
For now, I'm someone, I love kids, so I'll just try to inculcate the culture, Ghanaian culture into the kids. We are now coming up with the animated stories and the documentary of how this whole Akwaba thing came about. I love to be around kids, so I'll try to make something out of that.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, I'm really excited I'm talking to you because when I was 18, my friend Marianne Nyakwan Wusu and I went to a photo studio at Circle. And you know, all the photo studios had the kente pieces for this Akwaba picture. So when you go, you say you want the Akwaba picture and they'll give you pieces of kente cloth. And then you wrap around your body and take the picture. So I have one just like yours. The color of kente, the pose, the calabash, the whole shebang. And I took that picture and it's still in my living room. So when we decided to, you know, talk to you today, I was thinking, oh my God, this is someone, you know, when you say, oh, I want to be like you, I want to be like you. This is someone I actually wanted to be like. And I went all the way to go and do her picture and I still have it. And so I'll be thrilled to meet you. And I really am. But I'll still like for you to, for many girls who think, okay, I want to be like her. Okay. This is the woman we all want to be like at that time. What advice would you give them?
For now, there's something that I've noticed, like this TikTok thing and thing people like exposing, especially the ladies. I'll just advise them to like deter from that kind of act because it's they think that's the fashion or something, but it's actually not good.
You think they shouldn't do so much social media?
Yeah, no, not so much social media, but they're exposing themselves so much.
Like the silhouette challenge and the busted.
Yes.
You don't like it?
Yeah, no.
Why?
It doesn't speak well. They'll later grow to reject, regret it. Because I remember Madonna.
Mm-hmm.
I heard a story about her that she got to a time when she started making a family. She wanted to take some pictures and videos of her old pictures.
Of the internet.
Yeah, of the internet. So just like the way the youth of today are doing, they'll later grow to regret. I recently saw a picture of two ladies. I think they are JHS graduates. They said, if I go to bed with your man, he will never come to you again. And they felt proud. They felt they think that's
a cool thing to say.
Yeah, they'll later grow to regret.
Do you have any regrets?
Maybe my regret is for not like signing some, but it's okay. I'm okay. I see myself like Joseph's story. Maybe God wanted that to happen for me to get this far. I don't know, maybe I would have been dead by now. I don't know, because not all those I started with, most of them are dead now. So
your friends?
Some of my friends are dead.
Of natural causes?
Yeah. Some through accidents.
Okay.
So I'm just grateful. I don't have regrets.
You're okay.
I'm okay.
Every time I talk to a woman who tells me she's divorced on the radio, I ask them, what advice would you give to young women getting married?
Getting married. Okay. The first thing I'll advise the young woman is to make sure she has a good job doing. So if anything, she can support herself and the kids or the family. Most of the problems is like financial, most of them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Always have a good job doing.
Yeah, have a good job doing. And try not to expect so much from your man, because we are human beings. Human beings do change.
Okay.
So that's...
Did you have a good job when you got married?
I'm the type that I get sick when I get pregnant, even within 2 weeks. So... My whole family, they immediately I'm pregnant, they'll get to know, because you see from my face, mm-hmm. I'll get weak and I can't do anything.
So you weren't working much?
I stopped working.
And that affected your marriage?
I can't say that affected my marriage. I don't want to talk about it.
Okay, that's okay. Well, I'm happy you're here and I'm happy this is your favorite song.
Yeah.
So I'm hanging out with Angelina. For some reason, I always thought your name was Sewao. Every time I saw the picture, I thought, her name must be Sewa. Angelina Kometo. I beg. Perfect. Please play Angelina for us. Prayer, wa baby. Do you like that song?
I love that song.
You love that song. So you know how to dance, Angelina does?
Okay, yeah.
We shall dance today. I've got great news from the SDGs, the AFCFTA. Do you know about the objectives of the AFCFTA? The SDGs Advisory Unit of the Office of the President in partnership with the UNDP Ghana presents the AFCFTA of the SDGs Challenge on Asasi Radio. It's on every Thursday with Elvis Crystal. So you should listen, call in and answer some cool questions and win big prizes from the AFCFTA. Charlie, it's so hard to say AFCFTA. After. So you listen and be on standby this Thursday, win some cool prizes with Elvis Crystal on the Rush Hour. Here is music by Prayer, especially going out to Angelina. Nane Kwia Odro. Pacho, you're sitting down dancing with her too.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And run it pata pata, and pay you the empty no. Say me to me, no. Nine come in a bit, and tell in a Sunday, I'll get any moon. And run it pata pata, and pay you the empty no. Say me to me, no. Angelina Kometo, yeah, she very gasasa. Macarena Kemapuga, she come, she go be. Angelina Kometo, yeah, she very gasasa. Macarena Kemapuga.
Angelina can dance. Wow. You've got some messages coming here. Patrick says, hey, Ghana. Isaac says, wow. So she's been staying together. She has been staying together in my room all these years. Oh, my God. Anyway, she still glows. I guess you have a painting of the Aquaba picture. Hey, now she still doesn't realize the opportunity God has given her, okay? Anita says, wow. And again, she says, you go, girl. Hello, now please ask her if she got any royalties for her picture. Nope, she says she did not. Hello, now I beg. Okay, I cannot read this question. Shout going out to Nanaya Mantia. It's good to know you're listening. Maria Nyakwa Wusi says, nah, I still have this picture. That's my friend I took this photo with at a certain corner studio behind Circle, New Plan Filling Station. New Plan what? Trotro Station, Bus Station. Wow, nah. I really want to talk to her, ask for the phone lines. Unfortunately, that's all our time. What be your final words before you say bye-bye?
I'd like Ghanaian to like made in Ghana, like they should patronize it
made
more.
In Ghana,
yeah, okay. Everything made in Ghana,
okay,
yeah,
all right.
Like we see, we most Ghanaians see our products to be so much inferior,
but it's not,
yeah.
Well, thank you so much for hanging out with me. I am so glad you came. It's a real honor to see you in person. You are a legend, and I hope that you get what you deserve.
Thank you.
For your work.
Thank you.
You're welcome. My name is Na Ashoko. I've been hanging out with Angelina Nanekiodro. She's the lady on the Akwaba, poster, the one most of us have in our homes. With a lady in Kente holding a calabash on her hip. She just told us the history of the photo. She saw a painting and she thought, one day I'd like to be like the woman in the painting. And when she was 17 or 18, she went and took the photo, and today she's viral. She has not received any royalties for the work, but we are hoping that she will soon become a tourism ambassador for Ghana. Thank you, Angelina, for coming through. Thank you for listening to us. You can catch the video of this interview on our Facebook platform, Asasi Radio 99.5. Tomorrow, we're back with another edition of Between Hours. You be good, stay on top, and still rise.
Silly.
It's Mr. Drew.
Highly spiritual.